As you might be aware, guys, governments are currently printing a lot of money and pushing it into economies. In United States government is pushing billions into economy of United States, and in Europe, billions of euros are also being printed and pushed into European Union's economy. And just logically, sooner or later, this system has to crash because it is not sustainable. You can't push unlimited amount of money into economy. So as if we look around, guys, we can see that small businesses all around the world are being destroyed. All small businesses like bars, shops, they are being destroyed because of this pandemic kind of thing. But if you understand economy, you also understand that small businesses make 70-80% of budget of any country. Straight away here you can see that if all these small businesses will be destroyed in these countries, then countries goes bankrupt, and there will be some huge power which these all countries will depend on. Whether it will be some world government, whether these will be huge corporations which are going to be there, but they will be controlling the world, and the all country governments, like your country, my country, and any other country governments, they will have to do whatever that huge or main government says, guys. And this is just logical, because if you look around and you see that this is what is happening in European Union, any participating European Union country has to obey whatever is said from Brussels, from the main parliament of European Union. In United States, this the same applies. Only Federal Reserve is the main instance, which is pretty much regulating and telling United States government what they can do. So as there is a huge amount of companies also in United States, guys. But these are not governments which are ruling over the world currently. And in relation to all this, and wrapping this all up, I believe that we will need, or people will move to another cryptocurrency which will not be dependent on these governments and on these huge corporations. And sooner or later all people will start understanding it, or they have already started understanding it. And to my opinion, and this is only to my opinion, is that currently all world is being prepared for one global currency, and that currency will be digital currency. That will not be paper money, or that will not be particular country's money, but that will be digital money which will be controlled by some huge institution and from one place, and that money will be created for all around the world. But the problem here in this money is if there will be such a currency created, whether it will be world's currency or only digital currency of your country, you will be fully dependent on that currency, and you will be fully transparent. You will not be able to buy whatever you want to buy. You will not be able to give a loan to your mother or give some money to your kids if you wouldn't want government to see it, because government will see anything. And from the other side, if you will be a rich person, for example, or you will become a rich person, you will not be confident that you can store your value, because at any given time government can switch off your account, and from rich you go pretty much to poor if that is a digital currency, because you can't obviously or logically save any savings in paper money as we are doing right now. And that's for these purposes I think that people will start using such currency as Monero, and that's why I think that this cryptocurrency will have a huge potential in the future. Monero is similar to Bitcoin or Bitcoin Cash or Litecoin. This is payment method or peer-to-peer currency which you can use on blockchain. But the difference from Bitcoin or Bitcoin Cash or Litecoin or other cryptocurrencies is that Monero is fully private. If you are using Bitcoin, for example, then there is open ledger, or people can access Bitcoin, they can create bots, or create or governments can create some bots, or they can create some softwares which are tracking all transactions which are happening on Bitcoin blockchain. They can track people who are using these transactions, but they can track up to IP levels where these transactions have been sent from and where they have been sent to, guys. So Bitcoin blockchain is very transparent blockchain, and everything what has happened before, even before in history, can be tracked there. But if you look at Monero blockchain technology, guys, then you can't track anything. Another thing what you should know about Monero is IRS, or Internal Revenue Service, announced that they are ready to pay anyone or hackers who will crack Monero's code $625,000. So this is also another thing which just shows you that Monero blockchain is very secure and they can't crack it, and they can see what is going behind this. But another thing which you should know about Monero or XMR in general is, guys, that governments are fighting with this, and I believe that sooner or later they will try to remove them in Monero from all cryptocurrency exchanges, because this will be a threat to them. And just because of that reason which I mentioned at the very beginning of this video, because they want everyone to be transparent, and they want to see all transactions. And in future, like I said, there will be these huge companies, or there will be this huge government who will want to control all the world, and who will want to control all people, guys. And blockchains like Monero will be a threat to them. But from other side, people like me, for example, I like independence, and I will always go with the independence, guys. I am choosing Monero exactly because of that reason, that I want to stay private, I want to stay secure, and I want to spend my money as I want. And I believe that in future there will be more people like me, or like me-minded people, who also prefer privacy over not being private, and we will be using such cryptocurrencies as Monero. And that's one of the reasons why I am personally invested in Monero. I am not planning to make huge money here in short term, guys, but I believe that Monero, this particular cryptocurrency, has a huge potential exactly because of this future which are brewing for all of us. Because we people, we like freedom, we like privacy, and we like independence. And this is, and these are those factors which Monero provides, at least in my view, guys. So yes, guys, I think that Monero has a huge potential, only this is probably not in short term or short term hold, but I think that sooner or later this cryptocurrency will explode, and it could go even to the same level prices as Bitcoin. Currently in circulation there is 17,824,000 Monero, but total supply of Monero is 18.4 million, guys. And the last Monero will be mined in May 2022, guys. But another thing which you should know about Monero is that when last Monero will be mined, starting from that date ongoing, there will be 0.6 XMR tokens or Monero paid for each mined block. This means that after 18.4 million Monero, there will still will be added more Monero depending on how many blocks will be created. So 0.6 Monero will be paid out to miners for each block. In my opinion, Monero could go very high, but in longer term, I would say in 1, 2, maybe maximum 3 years, it could easily go over $5,000. And only because of that reason, that currently what I am seeing myself, that governments are destroying economy, governments are destroying monetary system fully, and I believe that they are going to reset it fully to some digital currencies, and those digital currencies will take off the freedoms of people, and that's why people will start using such cryptocurrencies as Monero. And these are just my thoughts, just my opinions, guys. I hope that you find this video useful, and if you did, leave a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel if you are new, and see you in the next one.